Insights for ArcGIS allows all members of your organization to use the power of geography and relationships to explore and analyze your data. Let's take a look at how some water utilities have used Insights to answer questions and discover complex relationships in their data. Insights workbooks, like this one, are the documents that store all of your pages and cards. And they are where you view tables, maps, charts, and perform analysis. On this page, we've seen analysis performed by the White House Utility District in northern Tennessee. They had noticed an unusually large number of leaks coming from one zone here in the southeast of their service area. When we look at this analysis, we can see that there is a spike in leaks in developments built in 2007. And digging deeper, we can see that these leaks are mainly occurring in condo developments. Specifically, looking at our map, we can see that two developments built in 2007 are showing an extremely large number of leaks. So why was this happening? Well, the staff at the district believed that this had something to do with the type of pipe that was installed in these developments. So let's bring our pipe material into our analysis. We can see that the suspect pipe is this green-colored pipe. And by looking at our legend, we can tell that this is copper pipe. Further investigation showed that the copper pipes installed in these developments were in fact defective. They've since been replaced, and the number of leaks has dramatically decreased. This is just a quick tour of an existing workbook and how Insights help answer questions for water utilities. Now, we're going to create a new workbook from scratch to analyze water consumption in Southern California. East Valley Water District has been affected by the long-term drought like many other water utilities in the West. They wanted to analyze trends in consumption to see if they could identify their most inefficient residential customers to work with them to use less water. For this analysis, we need to know where our customers are located, which is found in our meters feature class, and how much water they have consumed, which is found in our customer consumption table. We can join our consumption table to our meters feature class in the Insights Relationship view. This join is based off of a common field, in this case, a unique account ID. Now that we have established this relationship, we can use this inefficient use field, which is a ratio of their actual water consumption to their allocated consumption. We can create a map of customers with inefficient use by dragging this field onto our Insights page. This creates our first map card. We can symbolize this data as a heat map, and we see that there are pockets of inefficient use spread across our entire service area. So we need to dig deeper to determine if there's a temporal pattern to this water use, and if we can identify individual excessive water users. To see how water use has changed over time, let's create a time series chart of our consumption based on our billing date. This chart shows us that there is a spike in consumption at the end of September when it's generally hot and dry. We suspect that these spikes in high water usage are caused by excessive outdoor consumption to keep lawns and plants green. So let's follow that lead up and look more closely at our outdoor water consumption. First, we're going to create a ratio of our outdoor water use to our indoor water use. Let's call that new field our usage ratio. Insights creates this field on the fly, and we can immediately use it to create a new card to continue analyzing our data. Next, we're going to filter this data set so that we are only looking at customers who are using at least 20 times more water outside than they are inside. This filter takes us from over 20,000 customers to the 442 customers we are the most concerned with. We can further break down this data using Insights' new box plot, and we discover that, in fact, there are 30 customers who are outliers, using between 50 and 110 times more water than we would expect. This gives us a manageable subset of customers to focus our water conservation efforts on. So let's turn on our aerial photo and zoom into one of these customers to see if we can determine why they're using so much water. Well, we can see by looking at the photo that this customer has a pool, a large lawn, and a lot of trees. So it makes sense that they're using tons of water. We can now share this page out to our organization, and we can return to it at any time for future analysis, because Insights has documented all of the steps in our workbook. This is just a quick tour of some of the capabilities in Insights that lets us identify and answer questions like, why are my new developments experiencing so many leaks? And where do I need to focus my water conservation efforts? Insights is designed to be used in all of your rich spatial and non-spatial data to help your organization answer questions and make new discoveries. Thank you.